big aircraft manufacturers in the 30s. And the Tiger Moth was a military trainer adopted by the Air Force, so it was the first real mass-produced training aircraft. The 1943 aircraft, the engine is even older technology, probably 1920s. It ended up as a derelict wreck, but because of the value and also collectors wanting aircraft like this, it was restored a couple of years ago. It's a very slow revving engine, has a big propeller. It's quite noisy because it doesn't have a silencer. Is actually upside down, and this was for visibility. It's quite a big engine compared to a car engine, so maximum RPM is just over 2000 RPM, which would barely get you going in your car.
You start thinking about, you know, these guys who trained to fly in the Battle of Britain and these things, and yeah, it does make you feel a bit nostalgic.
It's very 1930s construction, a bit like a model aeroplane. It's slightly ahead of its time, and it's got a metal fuselage, and then it's got fabric to streamline it. Originally it would have been Irish linen. It's actually painted in the markings it would have been during the war, and it's got its military registration on the side. On the ground it's fairly delicate. If you stand in the wrong place or poke the wrong piece of the aeroplane, you'll make a hole in it. But when it's flying, it's very strong. This aeroplane, you can do 120 miles an hour, nothing will fall off. When you're inside the aeroplane, you can see cables from the rudder pedals, and there's pipes coming out from the bottom of the instrument panel. You can see the structure of the aeroplane, the tube work, and you can actually see the thin outside skin. There's not a lot between you and the environment. When you're flying in these sort of aeroplanes, you're very aware of the aircraft because you can hear it, you can smell it. All the hot oil on the exhaust, you can smell fumes from the fuel. You can smell the environment you're flying through. So Tiger Moths ended up as crop sprayers. People set up flying schools with them. Luckily, a few people, either with foresight or just the love for the aeroplane, saved them. And now we have in the UK, I believe, about 100 flying lovely vintage aircraft.